Once upon a time, there's a little ogre named Shrek who lived with his parents in a bog by a tree. It was a pretty nasty place, but he was used to that, because ogres like nasty. On his 7th birthday, little ogre's parents sat him down to talk, as all ogre parents had for hundreds of years before.
You're growing up so quickly. Growing up bigger by the day.
Although we want you here, the rules are very clear.
Now you're 7.
Now you're 7.
So it's time to go away.
Take some words of wisdom for your trip.
There's a little things you need to know. When you are grotesque, life is grotesque. Just keep walking.
Just keep walking.
And you'll find somewhere to go. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. With happiness all around. It's peaches and cream, and every dream's come true. But not for you. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. With possibilities everywhere. And just around the bend, there's a friend or two.
I know it's sad, very sad, but ogres are used to that. The hardships, the indignities, the endless stream of
Oh, hello!
Hey!
Welcome to Fiona the Musical! Yay! Let's talk about me! Once upon a time, there was a little princess named Fiona who lived in a kingdom far, far away. One fateful day, her parents told her that it was time for her to be locked away in a desolate tower guarded by a fire-breathing dragon, as so many princesses had for hundreds of years before.
Your papa packed your boots and bubble gum.
Darling, don't be sad.
A tower's not so bad.
Just keep waiting.
Just keep waiting.
And someday your prince will
fall. Isn't that the saddest thing you've ever heard? A poor little princess high up in a tower, awaiting her one true love.
Sorry about that. Technical hitch.
Hey!
And so, little ogre went on his way and found a perfectly rented swamp far, far away from civilization. And whenever a mob came to burn him at the stake, he knew exactly what to do.
Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I party on my own anyway. Doing what I can with a one-man conga line. Yeah, your big, bright, beautiful world is all teddy bears and unicorns. So take your fluffy fun, show where the sun don't shine. For a life like this, it's not that complicated. Sure, I'm fated to be lonely, and I'm destined to be hated. If you read the books, they say it's why I was created, but I don't care. God, being light is grossly overrated.
don't mind the mud, you'll get used to it.
This place is a dump!
This place is a fit for a pig!
Hello?
I can hear you.
We are standing right here.
Look, you all read Lord Farquaad's decree?
Yeah, we've read it. All fairy tale creatures have been banished from the kingdom of Duloc. All fruitcakes and freaks will be sent to a resettlement facility.
It smells like foam.
All right, but I call your name, step forward. Pinocchio the puppet.
Actually, I am not a puppet. I am a real boy.
That's your Pachama down there.
Stupid nose.
Fairy godmother.
Right here.
Dumped on a swamp. Man, I tell you, sometimes being a fairy tale creature sucks pie sack. Life is disappointing. Whoa! It's what I know. Outed by my nose, that's just how it goes. For poor Pinocchio, story of my life, always seemed to fail. Cheated by a fox, swallowed by a whale. That's the story of my life, oh yeah. That's the story of my life.
Three bears, take your spot over there by Pinocchio. Too close. Too far. Just right.
Right. It's never ending.
They dragged me from the pond. They broke my magic wand.
They blew a gondo sound.
Is but a witch hunt.
Mama's in the mud, mama's in distress.
They ridiculed my hat.
They said that we were fat.
They labeled me a fashion mess because I wore a granny dress.
Story of my life, booted from the ball, the party's on the wall.
But I'm too off the wall.
That's the story of my life.
And remember, if he finds you back in the kingdom, you'll be executed.
That's the story of my life. I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending, and it's right here. It's not how it goes. I always dreamed I'd get it ever after. If this is it, it blows, it blows, it blows. Story of my life. Always on the cross. Always in the woods. Always getting lost. Always on the ropes, always on the wing, always keeps around, and dreamer freak. That's the story of my life, yes sir. That's the story of my life, okay. That's the story of my life.
What are you doing in my swamp?
Well, gosh, we were forced to come here.
Forced by who?
By Lord Farquaad. He hoved and he pulled and he gave us his eviction notice.
Well, not my problem. You guys all need to get up and go back where you came from.
Go back? We can't go back.
Fuck, I'm returning to the breakfast.
The guy's bad news.
So, maybe you could talk to him? I mean, you are big and scary.
I'm also an ogre, which means I stay on my swamp and avoid large crowds. Haven't you read the stories?
You mean the stories that say I'm the big bad wolf?
Or the ones that say I'm a wicked witch?
The ones that say that I'm a wooden boy. What? Come on, guys. I'm not a wooden boy. Glandular
condition, you know?
Listen here, Ogre. I'm gonna spell it out for you. We don't want us here any more than you do, but you're the only one that's tough enough to stand up to that no good flim flammer Farquaad.
Tough enough? You don't even know me.
Foretold in my horoscope.
Can't you help us out with it ever after?
Can't you see that you're our only hope?
You're our only hope.
You're our only hope.
All right, all right.
Yes,
I get it. Attention, fairy tale freaks! Your welcome is officially worn out! Now, I'm gonna go speak to this Farquaad guy, get you all off my land, and back where you came from!
Time to say goodbye, time to say farewell. Time for ready to fly, time to really swell. Gosh, I'm gonna cry, time to say goodbye.
Right back,
time to say boost.
Don't get comfortable,
ogre on the loose.
Wait, don't touch them.
It's time to say
now, this can't be right. I'm all turned around. Took a left at the candy house, past that weird old woman in the shoe. Took a left at Quick Check? Now, what's this? Swamp? That's true. Duloc. Good.
Watch where you're going, Mary Poppins!
Where'd he go? Where did he go? He was... Never mind.
Where's that?
Ooh.
My back.
Good work.
I'm okay, you stay where you are. I'll be all right. That should be a lesson right here. Donkey should not be hiding behind bushes, but I had to do something to shake those goons. Guess it worked because...
I hear voices over here!
Uh-oh, help a donkey out, would ya?
Oh, God, it's hideous.
That's not very nice. She's a donkey.
Now step aside, Ogre, and let us at him.
Why? What did he do?
I don't want to die, I don't want to die, I don't want to die.
He's a talking donkey, a freak of nature. As are you, you unsavory beast.
Hey, now you're going the right way for a smack bottom, you are.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I am authorized to place you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? This is the part where you run away. Get out. Get out. Ah, 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 I need you! Ah.
Can I just say, that was incredible. They were tripping over themselves just to get away from you. I like that.
Oh, good. I'm glad. Now, why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Now, there's a shocker.
Say, so you lost or something?
No, I'm just trying to figure out the best route to Duloc.
Oh, Duloc? I know Duloc? You have got to let me show you the way, because I am like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own, thanks.
But nobody's fine on their own. Not when you look like we do. Hey, didn't you hear what they said? Man, this place is going Stepford. We've got to join forces, otherwise they're going to lock me up and I cannot go back in the cage. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata. Whoa. That was really scary. And if you don't mind me saying, if that don't work, your breath will certainly get the job done.
Listen, little donkey. Look at me. What am I?
Really green?
No, I'm an ogre. You know, grab your torch and pitchforks. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really, really.
Oh.
Man, I liked you. What's your name?
Shrek.
Shrek, huh? Well, you know what I like about you, Shrek? You got that whole, I don't care what anybody thinks to me kind of thing. I like that. I respect that, Shrek. You all right.
Oh, good. I'm glad. Goodbye.
Hey, 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 you gotta let me go with you. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Well, maybe you do, but that's why we gotta stick together.
Donkey.
No, 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 don't speak, don't speak, don't speak. Just hear me out. I might surprise you. I'll be a friend when others despise you. Don't roll your eyes. Stop with the moping. You need a pal. My calendar's open. I'll bring you soup when you feel congested. I'll bail you out when you get arrested. I got your back. Oh, what? When things get scary, and I'll shave it when it gets hairy. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. You need me. I'll treat you right and never act shoddy. If you kill a man, I'll hide the body. What do you say? You're not responding. I think we're bonding. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. You and me. We belong together. Like butter and grit. Like kibbles and bits. Like yin and yang, stern and trang. Like ing and chang. Attached at the hip, but not already hit the mic break. I'm gonna be on you like a fat kid on cake. Nom nom nom. Like Cupid and Psyche. Like Pop Rocks and Mikey. Wills, tick tick like a Velcro stuff. I'm the fuzzy side, you're the spiky. Like little kids with pajamas with those silly things at the bottom. You know, beaties. Like donuts and look at the donut. Donuts and diabetes. You need me. You need me. I need you. 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 Don't let me go.
You done?
Yeah.
All right, look, only because I'm lost, you can come.
Woohoo! All right!
But on one condition. You keep the jabbering and the singing and all that stuff to a minimum.
You got it. No jabbering. Man, you will not regret this.
Too late.
That is what I'm talking about. Shrek and Donkey, two stalwart friends off on a whirlwind big city adventure.
Here.
the cookie.
Oh no! Oh, I don't know what's going on here. Oh, this is scary. Where am I? Oh my! Oh God! Oh no!
It's you. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man.
Look what you've done to my legs! You're a monster!
I'm not the monster here. You are. You and the rest of those fairy tale freaks poisoning my perfect kingdom.
It is not a kingdom because you are not a king!
Oh, but I will be. Just as soon as I find a princess to marry. And I hear you know where one is. Tell me.
Eat me.
I have tried to be fair to you creatures, but my patience has come to its end.
Okay, well, maybe I have heard tell of a princess.
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
Yes, I know the Muffin Man who lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
He heard it from the Muffin Man.
Can I go now?
No, you still haven't told me where she is.
I can't.
You must.
I won't.
You will or I'll.
No! Not the buttons! Not my gumdrop buttons!
Then tell me where she is.
Okay, I'll tell you. She's a day's walk from here in a dragon-guarded castle surrounded by hot boiling lava.
Well, that sounds dangerous.
You want a princess or not?
Go on.
In the highest room, in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead princess named Fiona.
Princess Fiona? She sounds perfect outside of that whole dragon and lava thing. I'll have to have someone else go instead.
Big surprise.
Captain, round up your men, summon the citizens, and send this cookie to the swamp.
Swamp? That's the thanks I get?
Thelonious, call the royal chauffeur. Tell him we need to get my hair pressed. We're going to get a queen.
Farquaad, we'll get a queen. We'll get a queen. He has a plan. Someone will go against the will. They will fetch our queen. We'll draw a name. What a plan. He has. It can't fail. Good plan.
Are very simple. Whoever spots a horse and cart along the road, punch buggy!
Ow!
Fun, right?
No, what kind of insane game is that?
Man, haven't you ever been on a road trip?
No.
Well, I'm telling you, you need to get out more because punch buggy!
Ow, again!
I got you with that wagon full of hay over there.
Donkey, if you do that one more time.
See, that's another reason why I need me around. Who else is gonna fill you in all the wonderful stuff you missed out on? You may not know it, but you are one lucky ogre to meet up with.
Punch buggy!
Ow!
Mutton Kurt, at 3 o'clock.
Mother Hubbard, that hurt.
You know what? That was fun. Shall we play again?
No, I'm good. Maybe we should move on to I Spy, or I Went on a Picnic, or Monopoly, or something that isn't gonna put me in a body cast.
Look, Donkey, Lord Farquaad's castle.
Didn't I tell you I'd find it?
It's a bit much, isn't it? In the keys. Compensating for something. I'll forget it. Let's just find this Farquaad guy and get out of here.
Ooh, I want to stop at the gift shop to get a t-shirt.
We're not stopping for t-shirts.
Ooh, yes we are.
Welcome to Duloc, such a perfect town. Here we have some rules, let us lay them down. Don't be afraid to stay in line, they will get on the fun. Duloc is a perfect place. Please keep up on the crash and your shoes from your face. Duloc is, Duloc is.
it's you! What a terrific surprise.
Once upon a time, this place was infested. Freaks on every corner, I had them all arrested. Hey, nani, 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 no. If you had a quirk, you didn't pass inspection. We all have our standards, but I will have perfection. And so. Things are looking up here in Duloc.
They're looking up.
The things I'm cooking up here in Duloc.
He likes to cook.
A model that amazes. A plan with seven phases.
Bum, 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 bum.
Things are looking up here in Duloc. In Duloc. The ladies all look swell. The men are so dashing. Thanks to my new dress code,
the fashion's never crashing.
Hey, nani, 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 no. This castle I have built is taller than the cliff tops. A city like a postcard with a monorail and gift shops. And so. No one from the gutter in Duloc.
He's taking eggs.
Embrace the cookie cutter in Duloc.
We're all the same.
The upshot is enormous when you can shout.
Come for us!
Yes!
Things are looking up.
Here in Duloc. Hey, let's hear it for those Duloc dancers. Aren't they terrific, huh? Princess Fiona from the Fiery Dragon's Keep. Now roll that barrel!
Excuse me. Roar!
Ah! Hey, Lord Farquaad.
Maybe. Does the name strike fear into your heart?
No, but that little hat does.
Who let these things in here?
Look, I'll be out of your silky hair. As soon as you give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yes, my swamp where you dumped all those fairy tale creatures.
Newsflash, Ogre, that pit of misery is in the province of Duloc, and therefore under my jurisdiction.
Listen here, half-pipe.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh, this is too perfect.
What is?
You are. You're big and hulking and wonderfully expendable. My people, we have your hero.
Congratulations, Ogre. You've been chosen to go on a righteous and noble quest.
Sorry to interrupt, but we're on a quest.
To get my swamp back.
And you've so nearly accomplished it, you just have one tiny, teensy, tiny little task left.
What
What is this tiny, itty, tiny little task?
Oh, Walter!
And the dossier in her royal highness.
My people, your queen is on her way!
Things are looking up!
Not as odd as you agreeing to go on this quest. What do you know about rescuing a princess?
I mean, I've read the stories.
And I've read the sports page. That'll make me a cross-country runner.
How hard could it be, Princess Tower?
Oh, I bet we're gonna find out. I'll tell you that. What's it say about the princess anyway?
Well, it said that she likes pina coladas and getting caught in the rain.
Ooh, she sounds like fun. What else?
It also said that, let's see, it said that she had been locked in a desolate tower since she was 7 years old.
Oh, that's sad. Locked in a tower since she was 7 years old. 7 years old. 7 years old.
You're so weird.
Blah, 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 poison apple, boring, boring, evil queen. Filler, filler, bin that red, the 7 shorties on the scene. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, the princess wakes up with a star. The prince is good at kissing and melting snow. And manly hopes he'll propose on when
Flat. No one needs these middle bits. Whoops, did I do that? Cut the villains, cut the vamping, cut this fairy tale, cut the peril in the pitfall, cut the puppet in the whale, cut the monsters, cut the curses, keep the intro, cut the verses, and the waiting, the waiting, the waiting.
Get a trick. Why didn't you just make Farquaad give your swamp back? Pull some of that ogre stuff on him, you know, throttle him, lay siege to his fortress, the whole ogre trip.
You know, for your information, Donkey, there's a lot more to ogres than people think.
Example?
Example. Okay, ogres are like onions.
They stink.
Yes.
No. Oh, they make you cry.
No.
Oh. You leave them out in the sun and they get all brown and start sprouting little white hairs?
No. Layers? Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Onions have layers. Get it? Okay. Layers.
Oh, you both have layers. But not everybody likes onions, you know. Parfaits. Everybody loves a parfait. Have you ever met someone and you say, hey, let's get a parfait, and they say, hell no, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits may be the most delicious thing in this whole damn planet.
You know, this may turn into the longest day of my entire life.
Ooh, I got the perfect remedy for this.
Oh, no, please. I'm begging you. I'm not interested.
Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you gotta go somewhere, 'cause the fun is getting there. Oh, what the heck, I must confess, I love a road trip. Sing a song, hit the trail, forget the maps, forget the guides. Before you know it, you've made strides with me. And I know all I need all along is a path and a pal and a song. So I'm singing and I'm palling with you. See, it makes time go by faster.
Why me? Why me?
This is nice.
Tell me, what was my crime? He's as chatty as a parrot, more annoying than a mime.
Hey, look, a cat that's wearing boots. That's crazy, right?
Why me? Why me? A simple answer would be fine. Won't someone please send me a sign? What did I do to deserve this, honestly? This answer mine is last night. Why me?
Oh, hello there, little Bo Peep. How you doing?
Good. Have you seen my sheep?
Oh, I don't think I did see your sheep, but I'll keep my eye out, okay?
Okay.
What's so funny?
I just got the "he might be compensating for something" joke. Oh, this is awesome, Shrek. Look at this.
Ow!
Oh, you found your sheep. That was like quick. Man, what can be better than this?
I sing the song.
Why me?
The trail.
A simple answer.
It's the way to buy it around.
Whoa, you know what? Please send me a sign.
What did I do to deserve this honesty? This last of mine.
Ooh, you feel that warm breeze?
Aye.
It came up so suddenly.
That is because we're on a bridge.
Oh, I didn't even realize we're on a bridge. What bridge is this?
The bridge to the Dragon's Keep.
Oh, the bridge to the Dragon's Keep. So that intense heat I'm feeling coming up from under my hooves?
Yeah, that would be the Lake of Molten Lava.
Oh, the Lake of Molten Lava?
Donkey.
We are on a rickety bridge of a Lake of Molten Lava.
You'll be fine. Whatever you do, don't look down.
I am looking down, Shrek. I am looking down.
Oh, for the love of Pete!
I'm like frozen with terror!
Just give me your hand!
I can't!
Just look in my eyes!
I can't!
Take a step!
I can't! Don't let me go! Don't let me go!
I won't let you go! I won't let you go!
What did I do to deserve you, my pal, evermore? We crossed a bridge together. What a beautiful metaphor. So
why
I'm singing, me? And I'm out, and I'm drowning with you.
That'll do. Donkey, that'll do.
Man, you gotta warn somebody before you just crack one off like that. My mouth was open and everything.
Believe me, Donkey, if it was me, you'd be dead. It's brimstone.
Yeah, right, brimstone. I know what I smell, and it wasn't no brimstone. It didn't cover no stone, neither.
All right, whatever. You stay here. I'll be back in a bit.
Wait, here? You mean by myself?
Unless you'd rather come slay the dragon and rescue the princess?
No. Waiting is fine. I'll just sit here and twiddle my hooves. But hurry back! Man, this place is creepy.
You don't know the bloody half of it.
Ah!
Jeez. sorry.
Oi, it's a new guy. We haven't had a new man in a couple of years.
Shrek! Come back! There are people with beards!
Ah, shut up! You don't want to wake her up?
She gets really mad. What? Who are you people?
We're knights. We came to rescue the princess.
Just like you, apparently.
None of us made it, though.
We're the lucky ones. Everyone else is incinerated.
She keeps us around because we seem bloody back up.
What? I'm out of here.
That's what we thought.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god.
That's what we did.
Dragon!
That's what we said.
Another day inside my key. I get no rest. Cause when I start to count my sheep, you come around. I draw my shades and lock my doors. Still you come for what ain't yours. Like a hound dog on all fours. You stick around and around and around. You're gonna stay, you're gonna stay, you're gonna stay.
Sounds like a long time.
Forever.
And I got a hair appointment.
Another night, another day. All in all, you'll go the same.
Full
of smoke, you want that lift. When you fly around. The siren calls you from the beach. That pretty girl, that perfect peach. She is always out of reach.
Something to say here. First of all, I am not a knight. I am a donkey. And if you don't know that by now, you need to get your eyes checked. Secondly, I don't even like the princess. You know why?
I like a big, big girl. I like a big, big girl.
Fast me, boys.
He likes a big, big girl. He likes a big, big girl.
For you, I think you're bluffing, stomping around, all huffing and puffing. You want true love, stop with the hating.
Hunting Heart
is out there waiting.
He likes a big, big girl. He likes a big, big girl.
What's the matter with you? You got something in your eye?
Hello, princess, but he wants me.
What?
No great beauty, but he wants me. No one ever, 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 ever wanted me.
Specifically,
I'm gonna love you forever. Oh, yeah, gonna stay with me.
today. Ooh, I know it's today. Ooh, I know it's today.
Hello, is anyone up there? Can you drop down some hair or something? Like, come on. Oh man, I should have worn my cup. Phew. Oh man, I got one of the sleepers. Wake up. Are you Princess Fiona?
I am. Awaiting a knight so bold as to rescue me.
Ah, that's nice. Now, here I am. Let's go.
But hold us on, Sir Knight. I have long awaited this day, and I would first love to know the name of my champion.
Okay. Shrek.
Sir Shrek, please, take this token as a favor of my gratitude.
Oh, thanks. Makes you sweat a lot when you climb a tower. So, anyway, where's the door?
There is no door.
What do you mean there is no door? How are we gonna get down?
I guess the same way you got up?
The same way? All right, let's go.
But hold us on, Sir Shrek. Don't you want to savor this moment? Be it our first meeting, it must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
Man, like a crackpot magnet.
This is how a dream comes true. This is how I pictured you climbing in to rescue me. This was always meant to be.
That's nice. Come on.
This is how the scene must go. You're standing there, the light just so. Then you smile and gaze at me. Take my hand on bended knee. Bended knee. Bended knee.
Ow.
Sorry. And though we've only met, somehow I always knew it would look like this. When dreams come true.
Shrek!
What are you doing?
I have to save my ass.
Pray, Sir Knight, slow down a bit. Shutting girls are delicate. I've longed for this my whole life long. Now you're doing it all wrong. Down a rope, a steed awaits. That's what every story states. Riding over rough terrain. Past the dragon you have slain. You have slain. You have slain.
Tom, I did do this.
What?
No, get back. This is unwanted physical contact. I don't give you permission to.
Dragon.
Shrek.
Dragon. Ah!
Dragon repellent.
Just relax and take a breath. Hope he doesn't burn to death. Never mind the protocol. He's our hero after all. Tra-la-la-la-la, what's past? Is past. Tra-la-la-la-la, I'm free at last. In the end, the princess always gets her man. And underneath that helmet, I bet he has a tan. My champion, my savior, my dashing Romeo. He has a talking donkey. That part I didn't know. Wait a minute, look, it's just like in the book. Fighting over me, as it's meant to be. No more tower in the sky, slay the dragon and goodbye. Oh my gosh, we're gonna die!
Get back.
This is how I pictured it. More or less, I must admit, a thumping in my heart, a life about to start. I knew this day would come, and you would find your way at last, a dream
comes true. I knew. It would be today. Oh, you did it. You did it. You did it. You did it. Oh, you're incredible. You're amazing. You're a little unorthodox, I'll admit, but thy deed is great and thy heart is pure. I am eternally in your debt.
Ahem.
And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
All right. I hope you heard that. She called me a noble steed. She thinks I'm a steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle has been won. You may remove your helmet.
I'll pass.
But why?
I have helmet hair.
Please? I would just love to look upon the face of my rescuer.
Trust me, no you wouldn't, Tist.
But how will you kiss me?
Well, that wasn't on the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
No, it's destiny! A princess is rescued by a brave knight and they share a true love's first kiss. Duh.
With Shrek? You think Shrek is your true love?
What is so funny about that?
Look, let's just say I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now take off the helmet.
Look, I really don't think that's a good idea.
Just take it off.
No.
Take it off!
All right, fine. Easy. As you command, your worshipfulness.
You're an ogre?
What? Were you expecting Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually, I was. I was supposed to be rescued by a prince, not some ogre and his pet.
Well, so much for a noble steed.
You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Look, Lord Farquaad told me to come here and rescue you. He's the one that wants to marry you.
Then why didn't he rescue me?
Good question. Why don't we ask him when we get there tomorrow?
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset. We better make camp.
Camp? But you've just escaped.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite literally exhausting. We have to make camp.
Oh, well, too bad. We gotta keep moving.
I need to find somewhere to camp right now.
All right. There's a cave over there.
Shrek, a cave is no place for a princess.
No. It's perfect. Gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
Do you want me to read you a bedtime story? Because I will.
I said good night.
She seems like fun.
By day one way, by night another. This shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss and take love's true form.
And this is what I realized. If we escape the dragon, man, we could do anything. I could be a noble steed. I could even work the crusade circuits if I wanted to. I could even be one of those horses that pull those wagons full of beer. I need some hair extensions on my ankles, though, but I could do it. Man, who'd you be?
I wouldn't be anyone.
Just for fun, though, who'd you pick?
I wouldn't.
If you had to?
Donkey.
Like if a guy had a sword at your throat and he was like, you can't be an ogre anymore, pick something else, who'd you pick?
All right, I would pick that guy up and hurl him into a tree.
Man, you were no fun at all, you know it? Is this what it's gonna be like when we're done finishing rescuing the princess? Us sitting around our swamp doing nothing?
Our swamp? Donkey, I told you, I live alone. My swamp. Me. There's no we, there's no our. It's me and my swamp.
You cut deep, Shrek. You cut deep just now. What do you got against the whole world anyway?
It's not me who's got anything against the world. It's the world that seems to have a problem with me. You saw how the princess reacted. That is how it always goes. They take one look at me and they go, oh my God, it's a big, charming, ugly ogre. They judge me before they even get to know me. That's why I'm better off alone.
But you know what, Shrek? When we met,
I didn't think you were just a big, stupid, ugly ogre.
Yeah, I know.
So, there's really no one else you'd rather be?
Hero with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip, or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring upon a Viking ship. I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches, I'd taste the wind, I'd feel the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be, that's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story, one that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. Into the skies I throw it, the scars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and the night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke with wit and perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. An ogre always hides, an ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish were granted, life would be enchanted, or so the story say. Of course I'd be a hero, would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast, I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. We'd stand and stare, we'd speak out loud, we'd feel the stars ascending. We'd share a kiss, I'd find my destiny. I'd have a hero's how it would be. A big, bright, beautiful world, but not for me.
An ogre always hides, an ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark, you're all alone.
Oh,
I'm so big it hurts my eyes, but really, that's okay. A brand new day with things to do, so many plans to make. I've had 6 cups of coffee, so I'm really wide awake. I've always been a morning person, a morning girl. Hooray! Cheep, 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 cheep. Hooray! Cheep, 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 cheep. Good morning, dear. Say, have you heard? Today's my wedding day. I haven't met my husband yet, but I'm hopeful. I'll wear a gown, we'll have a ball, and dance forevermore. He'll take me in his massive arms and spin me round the floor. I've always been a morning person, a morning girl. Hooray!
What's so good about it? Can't get these stupid rats to follow me.
Oh, well, I think you may need to change your tune, mister. This morning, this morning, this morning.
Morning.
So, Princess, did you by any chance eat a few of those funny little mushrooms by the stream?
Oh, why, of course not. I'm just happy that it's a brand new day, full of promises and fresh starts. And I'd first like to start off for apologizing for my behavior last night. We clearly got off on the wrong foot, and I'd love to make it up to you.
You would?
Of course. You did rescue me after all. So, I've gathered a basket of berries for our trip, and I've made each of you a daisy chain.
Oh, these are beautiful, Princess. Aren't they beautiful, Shrek?
Oh, you'll grow to love them, I promise. Lead the way.
So, Princess, do you often frolic with rats?
And what if I do?
I don't know, germ-infested vermin. Not exactly what I expected.
Well, maybe you shouldn't judge people before you get to know them.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, tell me about my groom-to-be, Lord Farquaad. What's he like?
Well, let's just say men of Farquaad's stature come in short supply.
Really?
Yeah, but he's a little intimidating.
Oh, well, he must be.
And yet, very good at small talk.
Okay, what are you two doing?
Like, I'm just saying, you may want to lower your expectations a bit.
Yeah, like 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. Doesn't bother me. Not today. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
Lifetime of misery, right? Okay.
You chuckled.
Hmm?
When I said lifetime of misery, you chuckled.
Did I?
Yes.
Look, I'm sure it was very hard living in a dragon-guarded tower.
It was!
I'm sure.
All right, then.
Although, it must have been nice to have a roof and a cozy bed, which is more than I had when I left home.
You are not actually comparing yourself to what I endured.
Look, I'm just saying you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
There are things you don't know, you know, about me, about how rough I had it.
What, you ran out of shampoo a couple of times?
I mean about my life.
In that cushy tower of yours?
Cushy? Are you kidding? I had nothing. In that tower, fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles. I had only bare essentials, army cot, a hot plate and a chamber pot. And every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation. Out one window, isolation in my bedroom and very little headroom. 20 years I've sat and waited. I'm very dedicated. On the walls the days were added. Luckily those walls were padded. So I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
That was a very sad story, but I've heard better. I'm just saying, A for effort, thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had it rougher. Like that time a mob with torches burned my bridges. See the scorches, you're just whiny. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder. Would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was 7? So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
No more regards.
No Christmas cards.
Toilet, just
and
of you.
Every day was hell on earth.
20 years I've sat and waited. I hear it dead. On the walls the days were added. Love to leave those walls crowded. 20 years! My dad and mom sent me away.
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah,
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 yeah, yeah.
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah,
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 yeah, yeah.
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Did it, I always say? Huh? No? No? Alright. I'm ready. Bring me my chair. One, two, three, four, five, 678, 679, 700. Princess Fiona? Hi, I'm Lord Farquaad. What do you think? No, you're right, too formal. 10 million. Fiona? Hi, I'm Farquaad, but you may call me Maximus, as I've no doubt you will. Meow. No, too smutty. What light comes in through yonder window? 'Tis Farquaad and Fiona's the morning sun!
My lords, we have just received word that the princess has been rescued. She's on her way.
On her way, and so am I! Oh, my fairy tale princess! I always said I'd be king, and now look, that's the adorable piece of my master plan. Ooh, that reminds me, how are the wedding preparations coming along?
All in order, my lord. We booked the cathedral, and get this, the bands.
Nice.
Although I have been wondering if you maybe wanted to invite your father.
My what?
Your father, my lord.
You mean that horrible little man who got me down my entire life? That mal-tempered monster? That vile grunt who abandoned me in the woods as a child?
Well, he did have his reasons.
Lucky please. He just couldn't accept I wanted nothing to do with the family business. That lowly, dirty family business. My daddy was a miner, so he wasn't much around. Foraging for diamonds, a life spent underground. Daddy didn't talk much, he barely said hello. He simply muttered, hi-ho. And off to work he'd go. Daddy was grumpy. My mama was a princess who left her crown behind. Daddy was a true love, so mama didn't mind. I never knew my mama, but she could have been a queen. She married way beneath her. Beneath her knee, I mean. Oh, daddy's bed was lumpy, so mommy couldn't sleep.
Daddy built a new one, so tall and so steep. 25 mattresses she slept upon. One night she rolled over, and Mama was gone. So Daddy was grumpy. Me and my old man, a tale as old as dirt, a bitter distant father in a tiny undershirt. Daddy up and left me, left me good as dead. But now he lives in squalor, sleeping 7 to a bed. Oh, if you could only see me now, Daddy, I'd invite you to the wedding, but you have to be this tall to get in. Boys! My bride to be is gorgeous, a wedding dress designer. The guest list will be major without O'Dina Minor. La 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 la. Packs of royal lackeys playing violins.
Curtains of royal underlings.
Who will not let you in? Tricked out carriage.
Tricked out carriage.
20 stallions.
20 stallions.
With the coachman
named Ryan.
Big reception.
Big reception.
With the boy band. With some torture just for fun. Cause I will have my wedding, and I will have a queen. And once I get that crown on, you will get the guillotine. And I'll punish you, Daddy, cause I'm all grown up and bigger than you'll ever know. You're gonna pay, Daddy. It's any day, Daddy. I'm off to work.
Here.
What is it?
It's Duloc.
Oh, Duloc. I didn't realize we were so close.
Yeah, me neither.
Congratulations, Princess. Your future awaits.
Yes, it does.
Well, so much for that batch of Snothers I was going to make us.
Snothers?
They're like ogre campfire snacks, but a bit like s'mores, but instead of marshmallows and chocolate, we use squirrel gizzards and mulch. Oh, they just melt in your mouth.
I think I need to sit down for a minute.
No, no. No sitting down. We need to get the princess to Duloc.
No! I may never get another chance to try one of those Snothers.
You eat one, you might not get a chance to do anything.
Tip it.
I'm just saying. Maybe Duloc could wait till morning.
Morning?
Why not? I mean, I spent my whole life waiting for love. What's one more night?
All right, I'll grab some food.
I'll get the firewood.
Oh, sorry. Were you gonna? Yep. You want to just go together? Okay. My microphone? It's attached to the...
There's something going on around here. I've been watching and the signals are clear. A nervous laugh when she brushes the skin. The sweaty palms, the big dopey grin. With a giggle and the flip of her hair. I smell the pheromones in the air. Making goo-goo eyes over their food. They need my help here and setting the mood. Oh, you don't believe love is blind? Well, I got some friends who think otherwise. And here they are, direct from my imagination. Watch your step, girls. You gotta turn up the heat, you gotta butter the pan, you gotta make a move, and don't be afraid. Reach for her hand, maybe give her a kiss. She's waiting for a move. You gotta, gotta, gotta. You gotta make a move.
Snuthers are so good.
Didn't I tell you?
Oh, they are delicious.
And a little nutty, right?
Mm-hmm. I guess I'll be dining a little differently tomorrow night.
I mean, you could come visit me in the swamp sometime. I'll make all types of stuff. Swamp toad soup, fish eye, tartar, you name it.
I'd like that.
Shrek, I know you can't hear me right now. But if you could, I'd want to say a few things to you. I am in your corner, buddy, but you have got to tell this girl what you're really feeling deep down. So go on now. Now's your chance. And tell her.
Princess.
Here we go.
Yes, sir?
I was wondering.
Spit it out.
I was wondering.
You're so close. You're so close.
Are you going to eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you? You got to make a move.
You got to slip in the gear. You got to buckle down in here.
Sorry, I just got caught up in the magic of the night. The fireflies, that beautiful sunset.
Sunset. Oh no, it's late, it's very late.
Wait, what? I see what's going on here. You're afraid of the dark, aren't you?
Yes, I am terrified. I better get inside.
Wait, there's no need to be embarrassed, princess. I used to be afraid of the dark until... Wait, no, I'm still afraid of the dark.
I'm sorry, but I have to go. Good night.
Good night.
No, sir. I did not come all this way putting up with you and your body odor just so you can let her walk away like that.
What are you talking about?
I am an animal. I got instincts. And you two were definitely digging on each other.
You're insane. I'm just bringing her back to Farquaad.
So you don't have any feelings for her at all?
Look, even if I did, I'm not saying I do. She's a princess, and I'm...
an ogre.
Yeah. An ogre?
She needs to know.
Wait, where are you going?
to get more wood before your fire dies.
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss and take love's true form.
Princess Fiona. Princess, it's spooky in here. Princess, I ain't playing no games. Where are you? Princess? Princess, it's really dark. Princess, where are you? Princess?
Ah!
What did you do with the princess?
Donkey! It's me in this body.
Oh my God! You ate the princess! I'll get you out of there! Oh my God, keep breathing! Keep breathing!
Donkey!
Princess Fiona? What happened to you?
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss and take love's true form.
That's beautiful, Princess. I didn't know you wrote poetry.
Donkey, it's not a poem. It's a curse. I've had it since I was a girl.
A curse?
A witch cast a spell on me. So now every night when the sun goes down, I become this. This horrible, ugly beast.
You're not ugly. Well, I'm actually not gonna lie. You are ugly. But you only look like this at night. Shrek, he's ugly 24/7. Wait a minute, that's perfect.
Oh, perfect? Donkey, if Lord Farquaad finds out I look like this, he'll never marry me.
So?
So? I have to marry my one true love. The kiss is the only thing to break the curse and make me beautiful.
Well, Shrek's kind of an ogre, and you got a whole lot in common.
Shrek?
Yeah, I think if he knew...
No, he can't know. No one can know. No one must ever know. Promise me you won't tell.
Okay, I promise. I won't say a damn thing, but you should. Man, when this is over, I'm gonna need a whole lot of serious therapy.
Hey, Princess. How's it going, first of all? Good for me, too. I'm okay. I picked this flower right over there, is where it grew. And I don't really like it, but it made me think of you, because it's pretty, is what I'm trying to say. You are also pretty, but I like you anywhere. So please accept this flower with its petals and a stem, which represents my feelings and tells you how...
Oh man, I am in trouble.
When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, hello, fair princess. Oh, look, the moon is out tonight. You remind me of that moon, 'cause it's big and bright. And by big, I don't mean chubby. Obviously, you're not fat, but your personality is biggest, is what I meant by that. Sorry about that fat thing, I'm on the hefty side myself. I have to blame the gene pool, which reminds me
of... Oh, where am I going with this?
When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, I fail to do. I have a snowball's chance. Are my prospects just too grim? I've spent my life stuck in the mud. Now I'm crawling out on a limb. If words fail, you know what I mean. If words
she'll just take my hand. She sees me like no one else has. If words fail, she'll understand. She'll understand.
I can't think about Shrek. Not now. I am a princess after all, and really, who could ever love a beast so hideous and ugly? Princess and ugly don't go together, and that's why I can't stay here with Shrek. My only chance of living happily ever after is marrying my one true love. Sleepless night, pondering true love. My fairy tale I know so well has somehow gone awry. Looks can be deceiving, but feelings cannot lie. Do I love him? Last night I was uncertain, but this morning, Shrek, thank goodness, there's something I have to tell you.
You don't have to tell me anything. I heard enough last night.
Oh, you heard what I said?
Every word, especially who could love such a hideous and ugly beast.
I didn't think that would matter to you.
Yeah, well, it does. Princess, I've brought you a little something.
Fiona! Fiona, 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 Fiona! Blow a horsey!
Princess Fiona?
Lord Farquaad, forgive me, for I was just saying a short farewell.
Oh, that is so sweet. Oh, it's the ogre. Your land's been cleared off. Go away. That is so sweet, but there's no need to waste good manners on that thing. It's not like it has feelings.
You're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona. Beautiful. Fair. Flawless Fiona. Would you be the perfect bride to the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad, I accept nothing.
Excellent! Then for tomorrow we wed.
Tomorrow? No. Why, wait. Let's get married today, before sunset.
Ooh, anxious are we. Captain, ride ahead and tell them it's a code red.
Right away, my lords.
You're right. Why wait? The sooner the better. We'll be married by sunset.
There is nothing like a good night's sleep. What'd I miss?
Fare thee well, ogre.
Shrek, what are you doing? You're letting her get away.
Listen, I talked to her last night and there's something in
you. Yeah, I know you talked to her last night. You guys are great pals, aren't you? Now how about you follow her home?
But Shrek, I want to go home with you.
Donkey, I told you already. I live alone. My swamp. Me. No one else, understand? Especially stupid, pathetic donkeys.
But I thought...
Yeah, you know what? We've got wrong. I'm gonna build me a wall. I'll make it 10 feet high. See you later, pal. Bye-bye. No one gaining, so don't you even try. A 10-foot wall. I'm gonna dig me a moat. I'll make it 10 feet deep. And then maybe I'll get some sleep. Piranha keeping guard, so look before you leap into my moat. Take an inch and
they drag me a mile. When I'm out in the world, I'm under attack with a face that launched a thousand insults. Well, bon voyage, I'm never coming back. I'm gonna lay myself down, I'm not going nowhere. One room and one easy chair, it's all I ever need, and all that I can bear. I'm gonna lay myself down. What a fool to think she might love me. I opened my heart and let her walk through. She wanted Prince Charming, I wanted my home back. How lucky both our wishes came true. I'm gonna build a wall, the perfect place to hide. Hey world, stay on your side. The best way to conquer, they say, is to divide. I'm gonna build a wall, I'm gonna dig the moat, I'm gonna fold myself down.
Think life can't get any worse. You get evicted from a swamp.
I really thought that ogre was gonna help us.
He still might. Maybe if we close our eyes and clap for
him. Oh, grow up.
I won't grow up.
You're 34. You need a shave.
Oh.
What? Am I wrong?
Where's you now?
40 miles north, they said. There is a landfill with our names on it.
Landfill? Are you kidding me? What's next? A dunk hill? A septic tank? How low do we need to go, people?
It's time we stood up to Farquaad ourselves!
No, Gingy's right. We need to get off our fluffy butts and do something.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. Maybe that ogre wasn't the answer, but something better will come along. And we just have to wait for it because, well, that's what we do. We're fairy tale creatures. We wait for miracles. We wish upon stars. Why, my cricket always told me.
Oh, forget that, Cricket. If he were so smart, he would have seen that windshield coming.
What? No, no.
What?
No, he's not dead. We just need to lay low until this all blows over.
Lay low? It's too late for that.
Bounces and biggies!
None of this would have happened if I was a real boy. Why can't I be a real boy? Listen up, puppet!
We spend our whole lives wishing that we weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way, but it's they who need to change.
The way they think, that is.
Papa.
It's time to stop the hiding. It's time to stand up tall. Say, hey world, I am different. And here I am, splinters and all. Let your freak flag wave.
What?
Let your freak flag fly. Never take it down, never take it down. Raise it way up high. Let your freak flag fly.
It's hard
to be a puppet.
Little puppet.
So many strings attached.
Yeah,
but it's not a choice you made. It's just how you were hatched.
Let your freak fly away. Let your freak fly
fish.
Papa Bear, Papa Bear,
have I told the world I'm a Scientologist?
Scientologist.
I did some time in jail.
Yeah.
I'm filled with cussing down.
We don't judge.
I'm gonna shed my house scrub.
Go! No! Miss Ring, you work it out.
Let your freak fly away. Let your freak fly, fly.
Perfect. Well, not that perfect. Okay, right there. That's fine.
Donkey, what are you doing?
I think you, of all people, would recognize a wall when you saw one.
Yeah, but the wall's supposed to go around my land, not through it.
It is. See, this is your half, and this is my half.
Oh, your half?
Yes, my half. I did half the work. I helped rescue the princess. I get half the booty.
Back off.
No, you back off.
Stubborn jackass.
Smelly ogre.
This is my swamp.
Oh, there you go again. My, my, my. Me, me, me. Well, you just shut up and pay attention. You are mean to me. And you don't care about anything I do. You're always pushing me around or pushing me away. You're so trapped up in your layers, onion boy. You don't know how to express your own feelings.
If I was so mean to you, then why'd you come back?
Because that's what friends do. They forgive each other.
Go away.
Oh, see, there you go again. Just like you did to Fiona. All she ever did was like you, maybe even love you.
Love me? She said I was a hideous creature. I heard the two of you talking.
Man, she wasn't talking about you. She was talking about someone else.
She wasn't talking about me. Who is she talking about?
You don't want to listen to me, right? Right?
Donkey.
No.
Look, I'm sorry, all right? I'm sorry. I guess I am just a big, stupid, ugly ogre. Can you forgive me?
That's what friends are for, right?
Right. Friends.
Friends.
So, what do you want to say about me?
What are you asking me for? Go ask yourself.
Ask myself?
You want to be a hero? Now's your chance.
Donkey, the wedding will never make it in time.
Now, come on. What kind of noble steed would I be if I didn't have a plan? Now, follow me.
Can we just skip to the I do's?
Right. Go on.
Do you, Lord Farquaad, take Princess Fiona?
I do.
And do you, Princess Fiona?
I do.
Yes, I thought you might.
Well, by the power vested in me,
stop the wedding!
Shrek.
Oh, what is he doing here? Really, it's rude enough being alive when no one else wants you around, let alone showing up uninvited to someone else's wedding.
Fiona, I need to talk to you.
Now you want to talk? It's a little late for that, so if you'll excuse me...
But you can't marry him!
Why not?
Because he's just marrying you so he can be king!
What? That's crazy! Don't listen to anything he says.
He's not your true love.
What do you know about true love?
Well, I...
The ogre has fallen in love with the princess. Oh, good lord. God. Take this abomination out of my sight.
No! No, no, no. What if the monster has something to say? It could be worth a laugh.
Oh, you are awful. You heard her, ogre. Express yourself with as few grunts as possible.
Right. Okay.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream when every dream comes true.
Awkward.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. If true love is blind, maybe you won't mind the view. I know I'm not the handsome prince for whom you've waited. I don't have a fancy castle, and I'm not sophisticated. A princess and an ogre, I admit, is complicated. You've never read a book
like this, but fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. I see it now, all let in. I'll tear down the wall and clear a spot for two to be with you.
Your abuse for the last time, Farquaad.
Yeah.
We're not gonna take it anymore.
This ends now.
Power to the piggies!
We demand our homes back
and our rightful place in Duloc.
Right, guys?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. You freaks interrupt my wedding.
Freaks, eh? Well, I guess it does take one to know one.
Ooh, what?
Prepare to have your mind blown.
Hi-ho!
Daddy!
I can see that my invitation was lost in the mail.
Maybe if you hadn't abandoned me in the woods.
Abandoned you? You were 28 and living in my basement.
Loser!
Loser!
People of Duloc, your leader is a halfling.
Which is a lovely thing to be.
He's a freak just like the rest of us.
No, I'm not. I'm not a freak. I'm not. I'm a king. I'm a big man. I'm a big tall man with a castle. I have a castle. Bring in the lanterns.
Stop the wedding.
Fiona.
I wanted to show you before.
Well, that explains a lot.
Ew, it's disgusting! Gods, get them! All this hocus pocus changes nothing. I am king and it is binding. See? See? As for you, my bride, I'll see to it that you lock back in that castle, never to see the light of day again.
Actually, you won't.
What are you doing, you insolent beast? I am king! I will have order!
True love, Fiona?
I know. And I'm yours.
Aww.
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss and take love's true form. True form. True form.
Fiona, are you all right?
Why, yes, but I don't understand. I'm supposed to be beautiful.
But you are beautiful.
Aww. Once upon a time, to look like us would be a pity. But now we know that beautiful always pretty.
Lived it by the book. Now I know that's
standing here in all my glory. I am sweetness, I am bratty, I'm a princess, I'm a fatty, I'm a mess of contradictions in a dress. I am sassy, I am sappy, when I'm with you I am happy.
The little ogre came to live on a swamp with the beautiful princess.
And his best friend.
And his best friends.
And a gingerbread man!
And a very handsome puppet!
And a wicked witch!
A cross-dressing wolf!
And a good
and an ogre!
We are never
diamond-haunted hall.